Hello, everyone, and welcome to the chapter on attitudes. So first, we'll talk about implicit versus explicit attitudes. Explicit attitudes are attitudes that people tell you they have. So do you like monkeys? Yes or no? That's an explicit attitude. I can just also ask you, hey, how much do you like monkeys? And you'll answer me. That's an explicit attitude. That is contrasted with implicit attitudes. It's an attitude that somebody doesn't tell you they have, but we can measure it by looking at how much an attitude target is paired with good or bad things. And an implicit attitude doesn't necessarily mean that the person is lying. Their implicit and explicit attitude could be the same. So you could ask me, how much do you like monkeys? And I'll say, I love monkeys. And then you measure my implicit attitude and you're like, yeah, she really does love monkeys. They're great. So it's not that the implicit attitude is a hidden attitude. It's just that it is much harder to measure. And we measure it with the implicit attitude test. And it would take me probably at least 10 minutes and lots of back and forth explanations to try and explain to you how the implicit attitude test works. And it would be much faster for you to just go online to this website and take one of their implicit attitude tests, an IAT, and you will completely understand how the IAT works. Ambivalent attitudes come from having both a strong positive and negative feeling about something. So here, I can give you an example from my own life again. So I went on a dive trip with my dad, and I don't get to see my dad much. We don't live in the same state. And it was great. I really enjoyed this dive trip. First of all, I loved to dive. Second of all, it was really nice to visit with my dad. And third of all, we were on the beach. So it was a great trip. Except I was sharing a room with my dad, and my dad snores really loudly, and I am a very light sleeper. So I also have strong negative memories of this trip because I remember being woken up many times, like, you know, constantly all night long by my dad snoring. So much so that I think the last days of the trip, I ended up taking all the blankets and pillows and sleeping outside. So it was a great trip on one hand, and it was a really unpleasant trip on the other hand. I was exhausted by the time I got home, and I slept forever. So I have strong ambivalent attitudes about this trip. On one hand, it was really great, and on the other hand, I was exhausted. Accessibility has to do with how much is something on the brain right now. So when I'm diving, what's on my brain is how much air do I have left? And these are the dive gauges that you have, you take down with you when you dive. And that bottom one, the PSI one, says, how many pounds per square inch of air do you have left? And when you hit 500, you need to start making your way back up to the surface. And you check your dive gauge constantly when you're diving because you need air and you cannot run out of air while you're down there. And so if somehow you were able to give me a test while I was diving and ask me, how much are you thinking about your air levels right now? I would tell you, I'm thinking about them a lot because they're very, very accessible. So when I'm actually diving, my air levels are very accessible. But when I'm not diving, when I'm on the surface, I'm not thinking at all about how much air I have left because I'm not underwater. I'm in the air and I don't have to worry about how much air do I have left to breathe. So the accessibility of that thought of how much air do I have left varies depending on whether I'm diving or not. Conversely, chronic accessibility has to do with how much is something always on the brain, no matter where you are, how much are you thinking about this? And for me, unquestionably, teaching is always on the brain. I have high chronic accessibility for teaching. In any part of my life, if there's something happens, I often think about, okay, how can I use this to illustrate something for one of my classes? Or if I learn about a technique that helps students learn, I'll immediately start thinking about how can I incorporate this into my classes. So teaching is something I have very high accessibility. Probably when I'm diving, I'm even thinking about teaching. So Things that are chronically accessible are things that you're always, always, always thinking about.